Good morning all, and welcome to the another lecture of 8085 programming. Myself, Dr. N.D. Meshram, Head and Associate Professor, Department of Electronics, Sri Mathuradas Mohta College of Science. And let me share my screen. Yeah, so I hope my screen is visible to you all. And yes, so am I visible now? My screen is visible. So I was introducing myself. Myself, Dr. N.D. Meshram, Head and Associate Professor of Department of Electronics, Sri Mathuradas Mohta College of Science. And in the last class, what we have studied was a 16-bit number was stored in register pair HL. We have to write an ALP to count number of ones in the given word and display the count, right? So that was the program that we have studied. And for that, we have done this subroutine and all. We have done this concept. So we will just directly land on the program directly, so that it will be convenient for us to go through that. Yes, these are some of the instructions that we have used. And yes, this was actually the program. And due to a little bit of instruction fault, we were not able to execute that. But at the same time, I guess I have dropped that program in our group. And I said that this is working now. So yeah, I guess we will do that. So this was the main program, that we have to calculate the number of ones. So this is how we are going to calculate. So number of ones was 0B, and that is to be stored in register B. So this was the analyzation of the program. We'll directly land on the program itself. Yes. So this was the program. I guess this was the subroutine that we have loaded in 6300. So I will be just loading it on the screen. Yes, this was the program, and I'm going to try this on the 8085 microprocessor kit, right? I guess this is visible to you all. So let us start. So I reset, we'll go for substitute memory. We are putting this in 6300. So we are putting 06, then next 08. This is the count that we need to put in register B. RAR, that is 17. Yes, next D2. Okay, then we have 0763, right? Then this was the instruction that it was wrongly written. This is 0C, increment C. So we have not done that. Then we have 05. Then jump if not 0C2. Yes, then 0263. Yeah, and then at the end we are having C9. So C9. Yes, so this was the subroutine that we have written over there. Then the main program that is to be written from the memory location 62 reset substitute memory 6200. So I guess this is the this was the main program that we have to write. This is the simplest program, and we have just called the subroutine over there, so it might not have the jump or any other instruction. From 6200 we are loading this. So we have loaded the first, the number that was 56 and 7F. Yeah, then we are having 0E, okay, 0E, and then 00. This was for the count. Then 7D, this was to move the first data. So we have called this, that is CD0063, right? Then the next data, that is move A to H, 7C, right? And then we are again calling the subroutine, that is 0063, and then lastly we have to halt. So our result is supposed to be in the register C. So this was the program that we have written. Let me stop sharing my screen so that I might be visible clearly. Yeah, so yeah, it is like this. So we have loaded this, and now let us execute that. So reset, go memory location 6200 and execute. Something went wrong. Reset, go 6200, and where is execute? Yeah, here it is executed. So it is executed, and let us check what is we are having the result as. So result is stored in C. So exam register, register C. Yeah. So we have done with this. 0B is the answer for, say, the number which we have got, right? So that was the answer we have written out there. And I guess if we again see our screen of that, so we might be able to, this was the screen. Yeah. So let us check. Yeah, this was the screen that we need to share. Yeah. So this was the program that we have written, and this was the result that we have got here. So I guess this is what you have understood from here. So this was the result that we got, 0B. So it is stored in register C, right? So this is the program which we have studied earlier. And today we need to go for the another program that is actually to convert a binary number into a gray code. So shall we begin with that? This is another program that is at the number B20. Just hold it for a second. So yes, that is actually a number which is a binary number, and that we have to convert it into say gray code. So what is the concept behind that? That is what we are going to do that. So let us start with this. So this was I guess again my screen is visible to you all. So again, I'm introducing myself, Dr. N.D. Meshram, and associate professor. Today, we are going to do with this program, a number XX is stored in register C. Find out gray-coded equivalent of XX and store the result in memory location 6200. This is what we have studied in semester one, how to convert a binary number into a gray number, right? How you are going to convert a binary number into a gray number. So let us start with that. So this is what we are supposed to use in this program. This is a RAR that is rotate the content of accumulator right by one position through the carry flag. Remember this. So this is what we are going to use, and this is the instruction, and this is what it happens. So we have to move this to the right shift, right? So now how you are going to use that we'll see. This is another instruction that we need to use, that is complement carry. We need to complement the carry, right? So whatever will be the carry flag, it can be complemented by using this instruction, that is CMC. And this is another instruction, STC. So we don't know whether the carry is 0 or 1, right? For that, we are first setting it. So it will be 1, and then we will complement it, so that it will become 0. So we are going to use both these instructions in this program, right? So this is the concept. Now let us start with the concept of how we convert a binary to gray number, right? This is what we have studied in semester one. So let us try this example before starting that. So this is an example. So we are having this binary number B5, B4, B3, B2, B1, 0 represents the binary number. Now we have written the number over there, 101101. So this is a 6-bit number. Now what we do is we directly take this MSB, that is the most significant bit, to the first most significant bit of a gray code, right? So this is what we do. So directly put this one over here and now start adding the next number. This number MSB added to the earlier number and ignore the carry, right? So if you add this, 1 plus 0 will give you 1. So we are neglecting the carry also. So 0 plus 1 is 1. And 1 plus 1 is 1, 0. 0 with the carry 1, right? So we have to neglect the carry. So we have written only 0 over here, right? So we are writing over here 0. So 1 plus 1 is 0 with the carry 1. We are neglected the carry. So we have a 0. Again, we have to add this. 1 plus 0 is 1. 0 plus 1 is again 1. So this is a gray equivalent of this. Now what we have done actually, so this is a logic that we need to create while converting or while writing a program in this. So we have just shifted the number. If you are able to say this, we have shifted this number to the right and then we have added. But adding means we have to neglect the carry. So such type of adding can be done by using a XOR instruction, right? XOR, what it does? it adds, but it neglects the carry. So that is the instruction that we need to use. This is the simplest program that you are able to do in at your homes also. So let us begin with that. So this is the example that I'm writing in front of you. So if we have the concept of this, we have to use this instruction RAR and by rotating it and then XORing it. So this is the concept. Let us say that we are having the C, the content of C, we have loaded it as a 56 number, right? The number is 56 hexadecimal in H. So we are loading it in register C. Now, when we put this number, we will have to copy this number to accumulator and then we'll rotate it to right. So again, we are setting the carry. So it should be zero. So what we have done, we have, yeah. So what we have done over here is we have written this number in binary. So 56 stands for 0101 and 0110. This is 56 in binary, right? So we are putting this in register C over here. Now what we have done, we have shifted this number to right and we have also set the carry. So two zeros, one zero is added in the number. So while shifting it, if you are able to see this, so it is being shifted. So this zero is carried from the carry flag, right? Now this zero is shifted over here. This one is shifted over here. This zero is shifted over here. This one is shifted over here. And this is zero. This is one. This is one. And the zero is shifted out, right? So this is what we have done in by shifting this. Now, what happens when we XOR this? So then whenever we XOR this, Yeah. So whenever we XOR this, what happens? It is going to add. So this zero is directly going to shift over here. So MSB is taken zero directly over here. Zero plus zero is still zero. So we are writing zero over here. Even if it was one, so one plus zero, it will give you one. So this MSB is directly taken over here. Now we have started adding. So one plus zero is one. Zero plus one is one again. And one plus zero is one again. So zero plus one, one. One plus zero is one. This one plus one is zero with a carry, right? So we have neglected the carry and we have taken only the integer part. So one plus one is zero, right? The last one is also 01. So if you convert this binary number, the result in hexadecimal, it will give you 7D. So just look at that. So this is 7, 111. It will give you 4 plus 2 plus 1, that is 7. And this is 8 plus 4, that is 12 plus 1, that is 13. 13 means, what is the number? 13, 8, 10, 11, B, 12, C, and 13 is D, right? So this number is 7DH. So while we are doing this program, we should know what the result would be. So it is what we have to store in memory location 6200, right? I guess the concept of a program is understood to you all. So let us start with the program. So this is the program that we need to analyze. Yeah. So this is what we need to have. Yeah. Let us start with the program. So, yeah. So this is how I guess is it visible to you all? Yeah. So this is how we always write the program. So let us start with the next. Say we are writing this program from 6300 memory location. So we have started to write. Now what would be the first instruction? Yeah, the first instruction would be we have to take the data. We have to load the data in register C. So we'll move. What would be the instruction? It's of course MVIC 56H, right? So we are loading the number of which we need to convert a gray code, right? It is written in the program that is XX. So we can take any of the number, right? So we have taken that number as XX, right? So, okay. I guess this is okay. So yeah, so this was the opcode is 0E and we have loaded the number. And yeah, this is the data that we need to store in register C. So 56 is loaded. Now what the next instruction should be? We have to move this to the accumulator. What is the instruction for moving the content of register C to register A? Anybody can unmute themselves and tell. Kaun batayega ye wala instruction? What would be the instruction? We have to move this 56 in accumulator. Anybody? Unmute yourself. Hello?
Sir, MOV C2A.
MOV C2A. Yes. So this is the instruction to move the content of register C to accumulator. Means we need to just copy that, right? We are copying it. So 56 is retained over there in register C. We are just wanting to copy that 56 in register A2, right? And in A also we need that. So we are moving this content in register C. This is nothing but just copying the data in accumulator. So we have put the data in accumulator since only the rotate instruction is performed in the accumulator itself, right? Why? That is why it is called as the accumulator. So all the instructions are being, most of the instructions of this type are being stored in the accumulator itself and executed in the accumulator. So that's why it's a different general purpose register. So yeah, we have loaded this. Now what we have to do, we have to check the carry. So what for that? We will be using this. So we have to set the carry first because we don't know what is the carry. So whether it is one or whether it is zero, it doesn't make a difference. But we'll, on our side, we will be, to be safer, we'll be setting the carry first. So we have used this instruction to set the carry. STC is the instruction in which we can directly set or we can make the carry flag as one. So this is that opcode of that. We have set the carry. Now what we require? We require it to be zero because zero is to be taken in the shift, right? So we'll again make a complement of it. So initially what we have done, we have set the carry. Even earlier it was a set, so still it won't make a difference. So it will remain at a set because we can't use complement directly. So we are using that instruction after setting the carry on. So now when we execute this instruction, implies that earlier it was set and after execution of CMC, that is complement the carry, the automatically the carry flag has been set to zero, right? So this is CMC 3F. So we have complemented the carry. It implies that the carry flag is now zero. Now we can use that instruction. What was it? It was RAR, that is rotate right. So we are using that instruction rotate right 1F. Yes, we have rotated the content of accumulator through carry. So zero is also moved over there and it has been shifted. And then now we can use the instruction that is XRA. XRA, the content of register C with the content of the accumulator. So XRA C is going, the 56 is going to be XORed with the contents of the accumulator, right? So this is XRA and now our process is over. Now where we need to store the result? We need to store the result in the memory location 6200. So we can directly also the result is stored in the accumulator itself, right? So we have to store the accumulator directly to the memory location 6200. And for that we have an instruction. कोई बता सकता है ये वाली instruction? बताइए हम लोगों ने पिछले बार use किया था शायद. Just for a check. Anybody? Just for a moment. So I will give you only 10 seconds for that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, nobody. So we are going to use stack STA6200. Store accumulator directly to the memory location. That stands for STA. Store accumulator directly to the memory location. Specified that number, right? So STA is going to store the result in 6200. So that is the opcode is 62, and we are moving the gray equivalent number or the result in 6200. The program is over. So shall we halt? So we will last use this instruction. That is okay. We have this 0062, and now the last instruction is 76. And sorry, it is written as stop processing, right? So we have done this. I guess you have understood the program. Even if you not, I will repeat the program for you. First, what we have done, we have moved the content or the number which is to be converted into gray equivalent. So we are moving 56H in register C. So first instruction we have used that MBIC 56H. Then we have moved the same content, we have copied the same content in accumulator. So for that, we have used this instruction, move C to A. Then, sorry sir, but physics ka lecture shuru ho gaya. Okay. So I guess this is okay for today. You can execute this and you can try on yourself. If you have any problem, you can ask me in the next lecture, right? So by tomorrow, we'll try to execute that in microprocessor. So thank you very much for listening, and I wish you all the best, and stay home, stay safe, take care. Good day. See you soon. Bye.